Well, what have we got here on this nice sunny day? Wow, it's a Baroque palace. That's right, it's the palace at Rastatt. It's the old palace of the Margrave of Baden. You can just see in the corner there, the Baden flag, yellow and red. Let's go and see what they've got inside. Turns out I was on the wrong side of the building. This is the front, it's even more magnificent, of course. Wow. Wow and wow. Okay, the museum starts with this quite ridiculous collection of Imperial shoulder straps. Right, then if that wasn't enough, we're going to this room. There's all sorts of specialist shoulder straps, epaulettes. What we're seeing in a lot of this collection is trial items. This is not an issue tunic, it's a trial tunic, hence the goon light. One side has got NCO insignia, musician's insignia, and the other side doesn't. Not actually for issue, just for trial. And a lot of the museum's collection is like that. So they've got like some incredibly original items for that very reason. I'm not sure if I showed you in full, but like, kind of regiment by regiment. Different types of shoulder strap. Interesting though, they're not all trial versions. This one here is interesting to see. Shoulder epaulette taken from German prisoners by Sergeant Barrett. That was captured by the British and somehow it's ended up in their museum. General's tunics. These little dioramas, Battle of Sedan. Siege of Paris. How cool is that? Napoleonic section, but for me, the museum really gets going up here. Notice there's nobody else in the place. People harbour of the old former German states before they all unified. There's Hamburg, Oldenburg, Hanover, Hessen Castle, goes on, Saxe-Coburg, Gotha, Baden. This is great. Bavaria, Austria included as well. This is the 1848 revolution they had here in Baden. Plan of the city. And yes, the revolutionaries. Now this was, this is Rastatt when it was fortified, isn't it? Breech loading guns coming in. So rifles, or the beginning of rifling. This must be the War of 1866 coming up now. Grand Duke Friedrich I of Baden's uniform. A nice selection of Franco-Prussian medals there. This kind of grass. Yeah. There's Bismarck triumphant. A whole room of musicians. I should say that everywhere is absolutely covered in pictures and paintings. I started in the Imperial era, I shouldn't have done that. It's supposed to start here. It's 17th century. There's the Hanoverian army. I think it's the whole thing. There's other people in the museum. It's not just me. Oh wow. See grenadiers and kind of from which one's he? And a Wehrgeschichtliches Museum. By the way, this is incredible. I've clearly now started in the museum several times in the wrong place, because we seem to be going back in history. I really study this more before trying to make a new video. Journals of the First World War, oh, I can see. Oh. God's Passion, yeah. Like I say, all the walls, everything. That's an amazing part of this museum. That is Kaiser Wilhelm's tunic from the Guard of Corps, one of the cuirassier regiments, but you notice the left sleeve noticeably smaller than the right. The other shorts are left out. So let's quickly go through what's going on here in the colonial section. This is a tropical helmet with a spike, lovely. I think it's an 1891 model from the Schutztruppe in Germany, East Africa. This is a Southwest African Sylvester. Exceptionally large red bit in its cockade. One thing we find at this museum is a lot of the things they've got on display. That's a Cameroon Fez. See, the eagle's different to usual. Usually it's outspread wings, but what they've got here is a lot of trial objects before they were being put into actual issue. This is an artillery tropical helmet from the East Asian Occupation Brigade. That one's a bit of a mystery to me. What do they say? They say it's a tropical helmet for other ranks of the pioneers and artillery of the East Asian Occupation Brigade. I don't get it. No, it's not. That's what that is, I think. Except pioneers would have a white eagle, I think. This, I think, is a privately purchased helmet, tropical helmet. Probably used in a shoe stripper in Africa at some point, and that band around it in black, red, and white is to signify an NCO. This, I think, is a pioneer helmet from the East Asian Occupation Brigade again. 1901 model, I think. Beautiful, isn't it? That's my opinion, anyway. The Platz and the sauna. I shouldn't get them, really. I mean, they obviously, they got us a genocide like all colonial forces did. It's just a historical interesting one. SMS Castle. Look at this collection they got here. Imperial era tunics, right? How are we supposed to study them? They're up in the sky. I became interested in edged weapons of Imperial Germany. Oh my goodness. This could be days, couldn't it? Wow. I just realised that's not just a Hussar uniform. What do you say, an Hussar uniform? It's actually Mackensen's uniform himself. There it is. There's his EK1. There's his Field Marshal's shoulder straps. Whoa. Now they're piling things to the ceiling. Again, more artwork. I must say, it is noticeable that the artwork of the 18th and 19th centuries really glorifies the army, and the artwork of the First World War is quite stark and horrific. Portrait of Hindenburg there. What's curious here is his medal ribbon. There is a competence medal for the Herero campaign. Did he fight in the Herero campaign? I'll have to look that one up. So, they've got a little bookstore, but what's amazing is they've got books you can't find anywhere else. You're going to have to learn to read a bit of German, but it's probably time you did that anyway. That's the painting I scanned over very quickly. You can see it in full in there. I've bought a few of these before. I might be buying this one. Okay. So there you go. That was the Wehrgeschichtliches Museum in Rastatt in Baden in Germany. As you just saw, if you've got any interest whatsoever in the armed forces of Germany before 1918, this is an absolute must. It's incredible. If I had any criticisms at all, it would be I couldn't find my way around. That's not really a criticism of the museum. It's probably a criticism of me. As you notice, I found the back of the Schloss before I found the front of it.